We're back in the kitchen, and this time we're cooking an other meal kit, but this is from Publix, which is pretty cool because Publix now has meal kits, like the same way that HelloFresh and Blue Apron and Sunbasket and all the
they've had it for like a while now.
Yeah, we've seen it and we've been thinking about doing it, so we decided, let's just go ahead and try it. We'll review it because honestly, is it as good as Blue Apron and all those things? But the one we picked is the harissa chicken with basmati rice, asparagus, dried apricots, and slivered almonds. Mm. And obviously it serves two. It says that it takes 30 minutes, which is, sounds fast. And by the way, this meal kit was $16, which...
I've seen them go up to like $24. A meal kit is usually $60 with three meals.
Right,
so
20
that's
being
20
each.
Or 10 per person, whatever. That's a little bit cheaper.
It's actually a little cheaper, but with regular subscription boxes, you do get like, you know,
more choices. I've seen this harissa chicken.
True.
For a while.
There was only like three options that we saw.
Yeah.
And all the Publixes are different, so some Publixes have different options than others. Taste test, review, unboxing, haul, mukbang. No, okay.
Kind of, sort of.
So the recipe is actually inside of the like label, which is kind of cool. Just this, a small recipe. Everything's gonna be cooked on a pan. We're not gonna need the oven. Some of these meal subscription boxes are like super complex compared to like how simple probably this will be.
Sure.
Which is not always a good thing because we kind of like complex dishes.
I mean, it's fun to cook.
But most people probably don't.
I guess.
So I think this is more convenient for someone who like wants it to be quick and easy.
It just needs to taste good.
And if it tastes good, yes.
You know.
And they did include pre-cooked basmati rice, so that really speeds up the process.
Yeah, a little bit of time.
And now we would have to cook the rice. So in the meal kit, we have diced apricots, diced almonds. This is the harissa sauce, which I am curious to know what exactly is in this. This is diced yellow squash and zucchini, pre-cooked basmati rice, and diced asparagus. Of course, chicken, which he's already working on getting that ready. One thing I think is weird is that it did say to put the pan on medium high for 2 to 3 minutes, remove the pan from the heat and then coat it with cooking spray, return the pan back to the heat and then place the chicken on it. So also, why cooking spray? Why not just like oil? So we take out the pan from the heat, we're gonna add the olive oil or the cooking spray or whatever you want to use.
Spray, that means
I guess it's not much oil.
No seasoning of the chicken?
Nope, because this is gonna...
Okay.
You don't need to season the chicken because this is the seasoning right here, the sauce at the end.
Blue Apron?
I know.
You'll season.
You season every single step.
Right.
All these like meal kits like HelloFresh and Blue Apron and Sunbasket, and those are the ones that stick out, but there's also Home Chef and there's Green Chef and there's Plated and there's a million of them. They always want you to pre-season everything. So now we're just gonna cook for 5 to 6 minutes on each side or until it reaches 165 degrees Fahrenheit. One part of the recipe that I think is pretty weird that I've never seen in any of these meal kit recipes is the use of a microwave. They want me in a bowl to put the rice, the asparagus, the zucchini, and all these things, and then microwave it for 3 minutes, which is so weird because usually they're like, everything's on the pan. So we're gonna use a microwave. So I added the rice, the asparagus, the zucchini, then the yellow squash, and the apricots. They did mention they want us to add half a tablespoon of butter, and then cover with the plastic wrap, and then microwave on high for 3 minutes. So, gotta add butter. All right, the chicken is still cooking, and I went ahead and put the butter inside of the bowl with the plastic wrap, and now it goes to the microwave for 3 minutes. And basically, they just want us to keep that there for now. And then once the chicken is ready, we take that out and then we just add the sauce to the pan. One is to cut the chicken into bite-sized pieces.
Okay.
I feel weird about the fact that this is done. Like, that's it. So we're just gonna let the chicken stand for about 5 minutes. Coco's watching us cook. Hi. So now we're pouring the sauce into the pan.
No salt and pepper?
No. They didn't mention anything about salt and pepper. All they wanted us to add was butter.
Okay. Doesn't sound good.
I mean, unless this sauce over here is gonna be delicious, but I mean, I hope that's the whole point, right? So again, I know we're comparing this to like legit meal subscription boxes, but this is almost like too simple and too easy. Like we microwaved the side dish completely. Like just threw everything into a bowl, microwaved it. All we did was cook chicken, and then we're gonna put it in sauce that's already made. They didn't let us, they're not like asking you to make the sauce. They didn't ask you to cook the rice. They didn't ask you to do anything. They didn't ask you to cut the vegetables. So this is a great option if you're like on the go and you're like trying to just get it done. But if you like cooking, this is probably not that much fun because we find this kind of like, okay. It's not much to do. It's kind of like almost like boring in that sense. But if you're someone who appreciates quick, efficient meals, then technically this is great.
Right.
But for us personally, I feel like we want more steps. We want to do things. That's kind of the whole fun of cooking. At least it makes you feel like you're doing a little something, you know, better than just like microwaving microwavable frozen food. So better than that, I guess.
I guess.
It's more fresh. The big question is, does it taste good? So we cut the chicken into pieces and we are now coating it into the sauce and we're pretty much done. We just gotta plate everything and add the slivered almonds on top of that, and that's basically it. Step one, plate the rice mixture. Step two, add the chicken on top. Step three, add the almonds on top.
Taste test time. Wait, we didn't cheers. I'm a bad luck. Let me take one more bite.
Well, chicken's good. Whole vegetable thingy.
It's bland, but...
bland, that's... yeah.
But the chicken has so much, like, sauce flavor.
Not enough to cover all the vegetables.
Oh, you think so? The fact that the vegetables and the rice are not seasoned, the only way I can say it makes it better is because the sauce of the chicken is really overpowering.
Right, but if you don't eat... if you have just a bite of the vegetables and rice...
Well, I don't think you're supposed to just eat a bite of just... because if I just took a plain bite of this...
not good.
Just like nothing. It tastes so plain.
Yeah.
I think the point is to have it with chicken.
There's not enough chicken to have that many bites.
Yeah, it is. You can plan it out.
Sit here and...
oh, I do like the little hint of apricot, though.
There's apricot in this?
Yeah, there's apricots. There's a little hint of sweet. And I do like the almonds, making it crunchy. I mean, I'm a big fan of adding any topping that's going to make something crunchy. But the sauce is actually pretty good.
The sauce is good.
Honestly, it's pretty good. But it's not the best, of course, compared to like the HelloFresh taquitos we made and like all these amazing recipes we've done. This is like on a scale from 1 to 10, like 6 or 7. Like it's fine. It works.
It's okay.
And I'm sure that if someone's in a hurry, this is perfect. But
yeah, really easy to make.
It's really easy, a little too easy. A little bit more seasoning. Just that's it.
All they had to tell us was add salt and pepper, but.
Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and eat, but that was fine.
Yeah. Okay.
It was good to try something different. Toodaloo!